May I request our August gathering to rise? We will begin our program with the national anthem sung by school children. Namaskar. With due reverence to Guru Maharaj Swami Pranavananda Ji, a very good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Bharat Shevashram Sangha, I welcome you to the inauguration of Pranavananda International School, an old age home and laying of foundation stone for prayer hall. Bharat Shevashram Sangha is a spiritual brotherhood of monks and selfless volunteers devoted to the service of humanity, particularly the neglected and the downtrodden. Founded in 1917 by Acharya Srimad Swami Pranavanandaji Maharaj, this purely philanthropic and charitable organization has grown to have more than 100 branches. The name of the organization spells out its philosophy, Bharat Seva Ashram and Sangh, standing for nationalism, service, idealism and strength. We have amongst us luminaries who have consented to grace the occasion. We heartily welcome the President of India, respected Shri Pranab Mukherjee. We also welcome the Governor of Haryana, respected Professor Kaptan Singh Solanki, and respected Captain Abhimanyu, Finance Minister, Government of India, and the Public Works Minister of Haryana, Rao Narbir Singh. We also have with us on the desk General Secretary Bharat Shevashram Sangh, Swami Vishwatmanandaji, Foreign Secretary Bharat Shevashram Sangh, Swami Purnath Manandaji, Assistant Secretary Sangh Swami Ambarishanandaji. May I now request respected President of India to light the auspicious lamp and inaugurate today's program. May I request the other distinguished dignitaries on the dais to join hands with him. I now have the honor to invite respected President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, to address the August gathering, sir.
Professor Captain Singh Solanki, Honorable Governor, Haryana, Captain Abhimanyu, Maharaj, General Secretary, Bharat Shevashram Sangha, Swami Purno Atmanandaji Maharaj, Foreign Secretary, Bharat Shevashram Sangha, Swami Ambarishanandaji Maharaj, Assistant. At the very outset, I would like to express my deep gratitude and appreciation to Bharat Shevashram Sangha and its General Secretary and other office bearers for inviting me to associate myself with this beautiful program this morning. I have just laid the foundation stone of a prayer hall. I have inaugurated a school building which has been constructed, an old age home for providing shelter and taking care of those old couples who have nobody to look after them and take care of them. I knew the activities of Bharat Sevashram Sangh for quite some time because the earlier Secretary General Maharaj, Swami Vijayananda Ji, was also very close to me, and I have been associated with some of the very pioneering developmental activities of Bharat Sevashram Sangh. Sometimes back I had the privilege of formally inaugurating a state-of-the-art hospital established by Bharat Sevashram Sangh in Calcutta. This organization was established by Swami Pranavananda Ji Maharaj, who was a great visionary, born in 1896 at a village called Bajikpur, which is now part of Bangladesh. Swamiji, in his early life, was associated with the revolutionary movement of Bengal, who wanted to remove the foreign colonial rule by resorting to armed revolutions. Later on, he was converted at the very early age. He was looking his bend of religious mind. The Swamiji was inducted into the monastery, and at the age of 28, he took sannyas. The organization which he established is not merely for preaching the religious scriptures or messages, but through this organization he wanted to liberate our society, which was suffering from so many prejudices, superstitions, petty-mindedness. In the name of religion, all sorts of anti-religious activities and sentiments. He wanted to liberate the society, mind of the people, from these types of superstitions, obscurity, and social backwardness. No doubt he preached Vedanta, fundamental philosophy, preached the core civilizational values of India, which is immortal and serving the humanity for more than 5,000 years. The broad Catholicity of this philosophy, which Honorable Governor very aptly pointed out, the core of our civilization is Sarve Sukhina Bhavantu, Sarve Santu Nirama, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Mahakushi, Nukuhar Pavi. The objective of all social activities should be Bahujana Hitayo, Bahujana Sukhayo, not for self, not for individual, but for all, for community, for the society. That was the objective, broad approach of fundamental civilizational values. I am happy that Bharat Sevashram Sangh, through some of the very important programs, are trying to preach this message for more than 100 years. You are going to celebrate 100th year of your existence as a mission. And in this connection, the beginning of celebration is with establishment of some of these institutions. I understand Bharat Sevashram Sangh is not merely confined to Indian territory or geographical boundary of India alone. It has 23 overseas branches, 100 branches in India, apart from 500 plus Milan Mandirs, where the people, devotees, meet and share their views and listens to the preachings of the Sant Maharaj. But 23 overseas branches in North America, Europe, where you preach Indian philosophy, core civilizational values of India, which is nothing but love, compassion, self-sacrifice, not self-promotion. I understand 60 schools are being organized and managed, run by Bharat Sevashram Sangh. Almost more than 1,20,000 students, boys and girls. Large number of vocational training centers, which are the need of the day, are run by Bharat Sevashram Sangh. And I'm sure those who will come out of these institutions, they will be little different from the others, because the core civilizational value, compassion, love for humanity, respect for pluralism, respect for women, discipline, accountability, responsibility, which are the essential virtues of human being, are inculcated in the mind of these young pupils who are having the privilege of having education from the higher secondary schools run by Bharat Sevashram Sangh. I wish them all success in their efforts. And at the same time, I remind the society needs these voluntary organizations, non-governmental organizations, who serve the humanity and in a much better way than what the government can do. Surely, the government can do many things, but government cannot do all things. Still, there will be a gap. despite the best efforts of the government, there will be a gap, and that gap can be filled in by the activities, efforts of the social organizations like yours. Apart from education, healthcare is another aspect on which Bharat Seva Ashram Sangh is emphasized. As I have mentioned, I sometimes back inaugurated a state-of-the-art hospital of 150 beds in Calcutta. Many other centers are running these healthcare units, which are providing relief and succor to the people in need. In another aspect, Bharat Seva Ashram Sangh is well known for its activities. That is, when the people are in distress as a consequence of the natural disasters, whether it is flood, whether it is famine, whether it is cyclone, whether it is earthquake, Bharat Seva Ashram Sangh volunteers and Swamiji's appear in the site of disaster to provide relief to the suffering humanity. In the contemporary period, the wonderful job which they did in the flood of Uttarakhand, and very recently in the flood of Jammu and Kashmir, are appreciated by all. Shortly you are going to complete 100 years, but many more years I feel you should continue to serve the people, to serve the humanity, as all religion, especially Hindu religion, has overemphasized from the rishis of the Vedas to the contemporary missionaries, whether it is Bharat Seva Ashram Sangh. All of them are conveying one common point: serve man is to serve God. Service to humanity is service to Him. Please keep this message high. Move ahead. And I do believe, when people have conviction, when people have firm faith and belief in an objective, they can achieve what appears to be impossible to achieve. Once Mahatma Gandhi said that a small group with firm determination and conviction can alter the course of history, starting from Swami Vivekananda to many other sages have established that through determination, goodwill, conviction and belief in the service of humanity, no obstructions, no obstacles can stand in anybody's way. With these words, I wish you all success, and I congratulate all the supporters who have come forward extending their hand of cooperation and helping them. Please continue to do so, because your help will go to the suffering humanity. You are serving humanity through your contributions to Bharat Seva Ashram Sangh or other organizations like these. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Jai Hind.
Thank you very much. Sir.